Hello, I didn't see you there. So what's cooking today, you ask? Well, I'll tell you what's cooking. Another interview in life in lockdown. And who I have today in store for you, you ask? Well, I'll tell you. She's a powerhouse pinup all the way from the UK. Give it up for the most beautiful woman alive. Give it up for baby Daisy.
Hello, hello, Misbehave. I hope you're okay. And I just want to say thank you so much to Viva Burlesque for having me for this interview. Yes, hello, I am baby Daisy and I come from a town, city, geography, fuck, called Liverpool. Liverpool is a great city full of good culture, good people, big hearts. Meh. And I am a burlesque dancer. I have been doing burlesque for only 2 years professionally. Oh my god, this cat is being so mischievous. And I am also a pinup model. I've been doing pinup modeling for over 5 years and I'm represented by the Pinup Academy. And I am also a jazz / blues singer. Pepper, do you wanna come and say hello? Because I feel like you're... Come here. This is Pepper. And this is Pepper. She's my kitty.
Oh, hi little Pepper. Oh my God, I love animals. Don't you just love being in your home at your own space and looking this fabulous, Miss Baby Daisy? Well, I've got another question for you, darling. How did COVID change your life?
So my life has changed through COVID because I went from performing every week and living a very sparkly, exciting life. And now I'm basically stuck in the same four walls. Slightly going crazy. No, just kidding. I'm actually very grateful because pre-COVID times, I would never have this amount of free time to work on costume upgrades and, you know, getting creative. But yeah, we'll talk about all of that stuff.
Oh my god, babe, that's just amazing. And also Pappi wanted to say hi to you and he was wondering, what have you been up to, right Pappi?
So since COVID was announced in March last year, I was like, okay, you've got, you know, a few months, because I actually thought it was going to be just a few months, hopeful thinking, to upgrade your costumes and, you know, work on your craft. So I started to upgrade costumes in March last year. So I've just got a few to hand to show you guys what I've been up to. So I've nearly upgraded all of my costumes. These are just the ones that were like closest in my little dressing room. Now there's a thong in my face. Great. Happy days. So I've been working hard doing costumes basically every day, sewing my life away. And I have nearly updated every one of my acts. And also I have been singing a lot more and writing my own music, and I've just released my first single, Wondrous Place by Baby Daisy, available on iTunes.
I found a place full of charm.
And just, yeah, just basically doing whatever makes me happy, and yeah, this sort of stuff makes me happy. Makes me happy when skies are grey.
Oh my god, those boots and those gloves, it just makes me want to go back on stage as soon as possible. And I will definitely check out your website because what you make is just incredible. So baby, what is your highlight of this year, or actually last year? What's been your highlight?
I think the best thing for me to come from lockdown has got to be singing, because if COVID didn't exist and I was still performing and dancing and stripping, what's that? I don't know. I would not be singing as much as I have been, and I love it. Ah, I so love it. Honestly, it just makes me gleam inside, and it's strange because, you know, getting naked for audiences as big as they can be doesn't scare me. I love it. I'm like, yes, bring it on. But singing, it's so personal. I don't know, it's your voice, isn't it? And I'm finding it to be like a new way of me as an artist, as a performer, to express myself. And yeah, it's hella exciting and I'm loving it. The future is now, even in COVID and in lockdown. I don't care. I'm all about living in the present, and I'm happy with everything right now, like.
And tell me also, what has been your biggest wish? If you can wish for anything, what would you wish for, baby Daisy?
I don't wish for much because I'm actually a very grateful person. I'm grateful for everyone and everything, and I've got one. Even though I am grateful, this would be a awesome, magical, may I add, wish. So I would love to have unlimited air miles, unlimited, and also basically like access to whatever country. So visas and green cards could just do a, and oh, that would be so good, just popping off to Hollywood, be back in a jiff. I have now got the time again, so I will be relaunching, excuse my French, this month, so please keep your eyes peeled on Instagram. It is called excusemyfrench.vintage. It will be on Etsy, it's on my website. Yes, it is vintage inspired accessories. So I have gloves, hats, brooches, ostrich trim boleros, handbags, jewelry, all of the mid-century goodness you vintage gals need in your wardrobe. So this brooch, these gloves. Yes, please keep your eyes peeled, because no, I'm just joking, I'm not gonna start teasing you people, unless you want to. New habits. I mean, it's not a new habit for me, but I've made sure that I stay true to it during lockdown. It is meditation and yoga, because I just think it's important to, like, zen, you know, finding balance, and it just helps me take control of the day. And yeah, I really like it. Also, like, finding things that make you feel that inner bliss, you know. For me, I love to take a hot bath, listen to piano, light a candle or an incense, and just be at one. I found this new thing called No Secco. Well, it's just basically 0% alcohol. Oh yeah, baby. It's just nice to have a little tipple with your meal, or, you know, whenever. And you just don't get any sort of hangover, or you're not drinking alcohol, because now I've started driving, so it's like, oh, 0%. Yeah, I'm drinking no seco. You should try it, it's very tasty.
Oh la la, you just caught me a little bit of guard with your no seco. It sounds marvelous, darling, but I have to say, I'm sticking to prosexy. A little bit rosé prosexy will never hurt anybody, but I will definitely try out the no seco. So baby Daisy, darling, if you have to say one thing to our viewers and anything you want to say, what would it be? Ching ching, baby.
So my experience with online shows so far have been pretty damn good. I mean, the other week I'd finished a show and 5 minutes later I was eating a veggie burger lying in bed. I mean, it was pretty fucking great, let me tell ya. Normally I would be lugging suitcases around and people think burlesque is glamorous. Let me tell ya, it takes a lot of suitcases. Yeah. Oh, and actually I've just finished videoing a Valentine's show. And there was, I've still got my tassels on. I've just finished it. I'm gonna attach a video. There was strawberries and chocolate. What I miss the most is the backstage banter and the people of showbiz. Like, these people are so amazing and full of life and charisma, and they're just so fucking talented, and I miss meeting these new people, you know, in different cities. And basically, I miss having the power of enticing people and just showing them what you got. I thought I could end in a little song. Bye bye, baby. Remember, I'm your baby. When I give you the eye, and just to show that I care, I will write and declare that though on the loose, I am still on the square. Bye bye. Thank you, Viva Burlesque, for having me. Good night, God bless. Also, it's very good to sleep naked. It's good for the soul, baby. Night-night, see you later.
Thank you so much, baby Daisy. I enjoyed your craziness and I miss your face so much, and I loved everything that you were able to share with our viewers. So In the next edition, we're gonna have a more fabulous performers. So I'll bet I'll see you next time. And Pappi says bye everyone. See you next time.